So foam rolling, I know if you've been working with me, you know that we foam roll a lot. Foam rolling works on the principle of getting rid of adhesions inside the muscle so that we can work with our muscles at optimal length, thereby helping to prevent injuries. So think of it as a preventative maintenance for your muscles. It's super important. So the way that the foam rolling works is that all of our muscle tissue has what is called a Golgi tendon organ. And that is a protective organ that causes the muscle to clamp down in cases of stress. And the foam roller, which is good, right? Because it helps to prevent muscle tearing. The thing is that it stays clenched like that and then adhesions form. And the foam roller works along the principle that it's pressing on the knot, and it sends a signal to that tendon organ that it is okay. And so it's overriding the clenching down signal, and gradually it releases, but it takes time. So you're gonna, for most of our upper body foam rolling, you will be holding things like we do when, for the lower body, when it's sore, we hold on it. I'm gonna show you very first the thoracic spine rolling. We don't want to roll the lumbar spine. That's not a good idea. I see people doing it. Please don't do that. It doesn't do anything besides cause compression of the lower vertebra. So starting at the base of the rib cage, support your head, and you're just gonna roll up towards the neck. It's nice and slow, feeling movement in the thoracic spine. It's super relaxing, super feels good. So that's your thoracic spine roll. Usually there you don't really find too much that feels really sore. Maybe you will sometimes, and then you kind of hold on it. Just don't let tension come up into your neck. We don't want that. So next, since we're here and it's nice and convenient, we're just gonna do the lat. So this area back here behind the armpit. So what you're gonna do is keep it there right below the armpit, roll over, extend the arm, and then roll. So you're dragging yourself with your feet a little bit, and then push it back up, again looking for those sore spots, which I can't believe I don't have any, in the lat. You can roll forwards a little bit more if you think there's something there. So when you find something sore, go ahead, hold on it until the soreness either goes away or cuts in half. About 30 seconds, sometimes up to 2 minutes. Now, remember the longer you hold the stretch or the pressure, the more the muscle can relax. The bigger the knot, the longer it's going to take for it to relax. All right, so that's your lat. Then we're gonna go ahead and I'm gonna show you how to roll the tricep. So take the roller and you're gonna put it not quite parallel with the body, but starting at the elbow and then roll it back towards the shoulder. So you kind of end up all over the floor with the upper body foam rolling. And again, you're just looking for those sore spots. I like to, on my arms, I like to lay my head down so I'm not drawing tension to my neck. It also adds a little bit of extra pressure, kind of just like you do when you cross one calf on top of the other. Good. And then while we're here, we're gonna go ahead and do a little bit on the back of the shoulder, so the rear delt, this part right here. So rolling over, try to put a little more weight on the shoulder and just rolling, keep the arm bent so the muscle's nice and long, not bunched up. And you're just rolling on that scapula area and the very back of the shoulder. The next one for upper body is your bicep. So now we are going to take the foam roller and we're gonna place it kind of at an angle to the body, pointing that way. And then flip your arm so that the thumb is down and you're rolling there the front of the shoulder. But you also get the bicep. And now that spot's a little sore for me. You can also work it up into the chest a little bit. Maybe the pecs are sore from chest press or push-up or something. So again, when you find those sore spots, just hold it. Work through that. Breathing techniques are good. Big deep breaths, slow it down, and through the nose. So that's good. That's for your bicep and the front of the shoulder, a little bit in the front of the chest as well. Now we have another stretch. You're going to place the roller long, and then we're going to sit on it. This is for the chest, the front of the shoulders. So you have the base of the roller about at your tailbone, and then you're just going to lay with your whole spine long on the roller. Your head, the very end of your head, like where your head and your neck connect, should be right there on the edge of the roller. It feels very nice. Your knees are bent, so feet are flat on the floor. Take the arms up towards the ceiling, and then bend the elbows and let the arms fall to the side, opening up the front of the chest and the front of the shoulders. If you are very tight, you may feel it down into your abs. So this really stretches on the front of the chest, front of the shoulders, and you just want to stay here. Well, you can stay here for about 2 minutes if you really want to. It feels very good. It's one of my favorite stretches. Cool. And then I'll show you one more for the upper chest and the shoulders. So going back to our horizontal position here with the roller, it goes about at the shoulder blades, and then roll it up or down until whatever is comfortable. You want to bring your head as close to the floor as you can get it. Your hips should stay on the floor as well, and bring those arms back. What you're doing is you're really working on getting movement in the very top of the thoracic spine. And you're also working on stretching all the chest muscles, front of the shoulder, in the armpits. You can feel in your lats. And you're relaxing your neck. Also getting the different movement, opening up the front of the throat. It feels really good. If you want more of a bend, you can lay your legs out long. Alrighty, and then to bring yourself up, support your head, roll it on up. And there you go. All right, those are my favorite rolls for upper body. Have fun.